Hello everyone and welcome back to another train sim video. And in this video we're going to be driving a steam train today on the Falmouth Branch Line. So this is a line I haven't played before. I've played it before but I haven't done a video on it. I played it a couple of days ago, drive a class 158 on it. We've got a standard scenario here, driving the GWR Hall 4900 class steam locomotive on the Falmouth Branch Line. Take control of the Cornish Riviera Express on this rare occasion that it sees. It's taking the sights of the beautiful Falmouth Branch Line and docks. It's just a 25-minute scenario, so I thought I'd do that one. So the Falmouth Branch Line, I think it's a preserve line now, but it runs between Falmouth and Truro. It's only around 7 miles in length, and the running time's only about half an hour. I did a nice little short route. If you haven't got a lot of time, just want to do a quick route on train sim, then it's an ideal route, and it's one of the old routes as well, so it's quite cheap, only around £10 or so on Steam. As we're recording this video, the Queen has just died, so a lot of you will be sad about that. So there we go. So at Truro now, the Cornish Riviera has been diverted down to Falmouth after stormy weather at Penzance has diverted cruise lines elsewhere. Pilot this express train down to Trancor and to Date Maritime Line. So we are at Truro right now. Driving this lovely little steam train, quite a long train as well. Do we have a passenger view? No, we do not. So as that's the best view we'll get. As this is a standard scenario, we don't have to worry about time or anything. We can just take our time. So we're just going from Truro to Falmouth, just a direct service, not picking up any passengers. So take control of the Cornish Riviera Express on this rare occasion that it sees to take in the sights of this beautiful night Falmouth line docks. Let's take it to like that one, so it's a different ship hours, but it's coming backwards. It says 5769. That's carrying two carriages on the short platform there. So, I don't know a lot about steam engines, so that's sort of the most I can tell you. So, we better get going then. So, I've got automatic firing on, so. Oh, that's cool, you can turn around and you see the tender, you don't normally get to see that. What's that? I'm guessing some sort of thermometer. So it's going to forward, I've got automatic fireman on so I don't have to worry about that. So let's open the doors and let passengers board. I've only done one steam video before, and that was that scenario in the the Union of South Africa. That's a lovely big steam locomotive. This one's a bit smaller. I wonder how steam train drivers manage to drive a locomotive backwards. That was it's a bit lovely. Oh, you've actually got the drivers in this one, which is a nice touch there. And the male drivers, not like the women train drivers you get in the train sim world. I think that must be like a acceleration is pretty good on this same train. Normally they're quite smooth and slow to set up the same train, but this one, I'm going quite quickly, so it shouldn't take too long at all. I'm curious about that. I'm going to take this into service to the story, but still have time to pay it, so I'm curious about that. I'm going to take 9 minutes to get three of each day to get that one. Speed and a steam engine normally starts at the first of the hand and the rear of 75%. You try to drop in speed regulator and use it for one minute from the top hand. It's a good very slow. We've got automatic climate, so you have to go through about cold water levels. Thank you. finish.